tour, and I'll be drawing from music from different parts of my career, and featuring four guitars I brought with me tonight to play for you. So we'll do a bit more on the Spanish guitar. I'm going to draw from Turbulence, and this time it's Corkscrew. Heritage Review, and it's drawn from some Spanish themes I heard Carlos Montoya play many years ago. Thank you. I've travelled from there, of course, that's why I'm here, and spent a lot of time in the West Country since, in fact, since Yes went to rehearse the Yes album, that helped me discover a certain place, and in Devon. I've enjoyed that very much, but London's still got that sort of basic roots feel with me. And I used to like this song called The Streets of London by Ralph McTell. I don't know if you know it, but it's quite a sweet song. So instead of singing that, and I thought, well, I've never sung like that well, but like my own piece. So I was writing this tune, and I thought, yeah, you know, this is really my London theme. So I'm going to play that for you next, when I've just got this little thing adjusted. And it's, I recorded this for the Steve Howe album. Go there. And it's called Surface Tension. Thank you. music for all ages, all the different age. As the links span out endless caresses for the freedom of life everlasting. Guitar, and it's one of my ones very close to my heart. This is called Mood for a Day. a new recording of that actually with the orchestra arranged by and conducted by Dave Harmon. And the symphonic music video. Yes. It's a controversial there, but yeah. Doesn't hurt. I think we're all too busy getting on with other things. Yeah, the guitar I just put down, that was made in Japan, handmade by Kohono, his name was, and I got that in 1973 when we were touring, in fact, over the Atlantic Oceans in Japan. And so it's still holding up to my foundings. This one's from Nazareth, Pennsylvania. You recognize that bit? I don't, it's not in the light, hang on.
That time of year.
Yeah, oh dear. 88, something like that. In fact, it was hanging on John Marshall's wall, and I called him one day. I said, God, I have a Martin Tours thing. He said, well, I've got one on the wall. Send it to me. And this is the one. So on to 12 string. As you see, I've got lots more of these little white bits. And do you know that sometimes you turn them and absolutely nothing happens? The next tune I'm going to play has brought me quite a lot of good fortune besides being nominated for a Grammy in 1992 for Best Instrumental. It was part of one of the most expensive and overproduced Yes Records, Union. Excuse me. And also, it brought me, a friend of mine came to me and said, I heard this record and I want you to produce my record. And that was a jazz guitarist called Martin Taylor. I know you're going to hear about him soon. He's a very colossal worker and an inspiration. So anyway, this piece is called Masquerade. Remember that one.
applause for you.
And if I've got a torting guitar in my hand, I ought to play that anyway. We go to a different period of work. Yeah. Thank you. I've got your blessing. We do. We do a bit of everything. This is a bit of everything show, you know.
Yeah.
After, you're not supposed to know about that one. It's a bootleg. This man's got a bootleg. Arrest him. You would do in Brazil if you were in Brazil. Anyway, no, I don't mean Brazil the country, but Brazil the movie. Yeah. So, so I'm going to look at another period of time. 1986, we were together. I was together with Steve Hackett. We put GTR together. We spent 6 months writing and rehearsing, 6 months recording with Jeff Down, 6 months touring. And as you know, life teaches you, some things don't last. And that one unfortunately didn't, although, you know, everybody tried their best, as we do. And from there, I'm going to play Sketches in the Sun and finish up to us. Spotlight there, really. I suppose that was a bit of a, yeah. So anyway, I'm switching to electric guitar for a while. I'm going to come back to my other acoustic in a few minutes. And I'm going to start by playing you a piece. I hope that all of you have got a favourite aunt, whether she's alive with us or passed on. And I've got a favourite aunt, and she passed on recently, and her name's Dorothy. And she was really, really sweet, you know, like all the kids need a good aunt. So I'm going to play you this tune when I've had another sip of this. What is it, in vodka? Oh. I thought I'd spare any of you shouting it out, I'd say it. So, Dorothy. Yeah, I kind of think when I change to electric guitar, I'm starting to use the sound much more than, of course, you play an acoustic guitar, you play the music that you're going to play, and you develop that sound within it. But a lot of things are geared up with, well, I suppose, the use of technology with electric guitar. But this one started way back and just uses regular sort of country sound. This one's called Bareback. Thank you.
you.
Yes Elm themes and Turbulence themes. Here's a tune called, I had a bit of copyright problem with this one actually. It's called Diary of a Man Who Disappeared, and they wanted to call it Diary of a Man Who Vanished. And I said, why? And they said, well, there's another tune called Diary of a Man. I said, I can't find it. But they did. So there's a few records with Vanished, but I still call it Diary of a Man Who Disappeared. I'd like to apologise for anybody who went to manage this morning hoping to meet me to do some signing, because in fact the book's just coming out and we're going to do it tomorrow at 10:30 if anybody can come along to manage. The book's just come out, it's called Steve Abdal for the Hitchhiker. I've also used these four and about 106 other ones are in the collection too. So we're looking at those and working on different parts of the usage of the guitars, not so much just pictures, because I think a lot of guitar books get a little boring. So I'm going to play, this piece is called Sweet Thunder. It's a little bit warm and jazzy. Thank you. on the electric guitar for the time being. Come back to it maybe later. This one's called Meadow Rag. Through the jazz guitarist Martin Taylor that I told you about. He makes lovely guitars, and I hope you like it. I hope I like it tonight. Yeah, I'm going to start on this one with a tune that's specially designed for anybody without a non-essential second initial. Thank you. together some tunes I picked up along the way from the Chilakins of Mel Travis and the like, and they're all American tunes, folk tunes, and I call this Country Mix. I did a tune there where I used the Fender Steel guitar to take the melody. And in fact, at the end of GTR, we'd started doing a tune. This is partly why Nigel Glockman's playing drums on this particular track, because we were doing that with GTR. Max Bacon was singing this song. I'll do it for you. It's called Running the Human Race. This is just settling down, you know. I've run out of the jokes on the tuning machine here, so here we are. Just coming round to my way of thinking. Yeah, I mean, I've been saying that here on stages for 32 years. I worked it out the other day since the food. The Super Cats. And up until this year, I've hardly said more than about three words per night. As you might have noticed, I go on and on and on. Of course, not necessarily. Could be doing it in my spare time. So this song, Running the Human Race. Thank you. touring this tour started in America. I did about a dozen shows in England earlier in the year, and then got on with Symphonic, and then came back to his tour. Picked it up at November 22nd in San Diego, so I went right from the west over to the east. It's great. In fact, on the way we saw lots of cactus. This is Cactus Boogie.
This is the peace, all that
track, in fact, I then came down and played on, and I'm this is going to work. So this year has also been exciting because I got back together and worked with Bill Bruford. Dave Palmer and Tim Harris, and also we were lucky enough to get John to come along and sing one song. So this is in the memory of Symphonic and Fragile. Thank you. you. Thank you very much, New York. Great fun, thanks. I'd like to finish up now with the very first guitar instrumental I wrote. And this one's called Clap. Thank you.
Girls flying. Peak Production.
Thank you.
Let me take you down the streets of London. I'll show you something that's bound to change your mind. Well, that comes from a song called The Streets of London by Ralph McTell. I like it very much. But I ended up writing my own tune and thinking that it was my London theme. This is a piece called Surface Tension.
know, I like to dabble on all sorts of different guitars, but I do very much respect guitarists who dedicate their whole life, particularly maybe to the classical guitar, like Julian Bream and John Williams and Carlos Bonnell. Terrific dedication. The granddaddy of them all was, of course, Andre Segovia. Yeah! He was really quite remarkable. I had the chance to see him three times, once in Switzerland, twice at the Royal Festival Hall. And each time he would be quite remarkably, just beautiful, beautifully romantic guitar. And he would come on and do his encores, and they would be very short cadenzas and minuet pieces. And then, of course, it would take a little while for him to walk back, because he's quite an old gentleman. And a couple of these times he would come back, and so he would say, "I'm very sorry, but my guitar is tired." Spanish guitar and move on to another instrument, and finish with something very dear to my heart, Mood for a Day. Thank you.
Brought me quite a lot of good fortune. I got nominated for Best Instrumental Grammy nomination in 1992. It also was on one of the most extravagant and overproduced Yes records, The Union. And, so yeah, good tour. And yeah, I think it was good. 85 shows in all over the place. I came here to, of course. I'm not saying anything, wasn't it? But there's something I've always got to play when I have a first time. It's an introduction, here we go. In the mid-80s, I got together with Steve Hackett and formed GTR. And,
we kicked that idea around for about a year. In fact, you know, there was a kind of a long period where we didn't know what we were doing. So then we came out with it. 6 months recording and all that, touring. It just teaches you that sometimes things don't last even when you want them to. So you make it work by, you know, getting around it and finding solutions. So fortunately, I went on to do ABWH with John. One thing leads to another. Sometimes you turn these and nothing happens. It's hell. You know, why don't they put them there if they don't do anything? Of course, I've got more of them on this guitar. I think I'll have one with 24 strings. See how that is. So anyway, from that particular album, GTR, I'm going to play on acoustic guitar and switch guitars after this piece. Sketches in the Sun. Yeah. Thank you. On electric guitar by playing this piece next piece. It's called Meadow Rag. I start putting things out and saying to you, what is this? You can spot what it is. I'm not here to play games. People who maybe came along to Manny's today hoping to get some signatures on my new book called The Steve Howe Guitar Collection. Maybe nobody goes there. Nobody goes there. But anyway, we're doing it tomorrow instead. We didn't get in from Washington until 5:15 this morning. So we were playing in Washington last night and we tried to get here overnight, but it was literally overnight. So anyway, we're doing that tomorrow on my book, so clear on. I'm going to start by playing this guitar piece for anybody without a second initial.
first guy I heard playing in that style at all was, he had two really great songs. It was Big Blue Brunswick, and he had a couple of songs. One was, I was just minding my own business, just leaving other people's alone. And the other song was called Glory of Love, and I'll do a little snippet of it for you all, and it's called The Glory of Love. Tunes I picked up along the way, really, from Chet Atkins and Mel Travis. Tunes of yours, traditional American tunes, and I call this medley Country Mix. Is on Turbulence and give you an idea of what it was like the way I originally wrote it, which wasn't a tune at all but a song. And this is called Running the Human Race. Mm-hmm.
We don't get a lot of cactus growing in England, really. It's the wrong sort of climate. This next piece is Cactus Boogie.
Thank you.
same thing every gap. We just
turn the session. with Bill Bruford extensively for that. And you with David Palmer making the record, John came over and sang one song for us, which we were all pleased about. And we're going to look at one of those tunes now. Here it comes. Valley of Rocks.
Don't mark that as well. But it's time to play one more tune for you tonight. I'm going to play the very first guitar instrumental I wrote. This one I think you'll know. It's called Clap. Sorry, I wasn't ignoring you, I was just looking for the lead. I've got a strat. So I thought thought this the second house I'd do something I don't do all the time, which is tap dance, really. Not necessarily, because I could be tap dancing in my spare time, but I'll leave that one to settle for a while. I often feel like a stand-up comic without any jokes. And after all these 32 years of playing on stage, it's really quite amazing. Yeah! You know, the first time I ever went on stage, I said, never again. I'll never go on stage again. Because we didn't tune up, we didn't rehearse, and nobody played in time. So I thought if that's playing with other people, then, you know, it's not for me, man, not for me. But it all changed, of course. I got the hunger, which my my boys have now got, to go out and play and perform and things. And so, Italy. Not necessarily. I mean, it came from Italy, let's say. Here's quite a special piece that I'd like to play for you tonight. We'll try this one.
for right now. Go over.